गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू इंग्लिश क्लास. सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू बिगिन अ न्यू लेसन, द क्लॉक दैट वन द प्राइज. यू कैन सी इन द पिक्चर देर आर टू लवली क्लॉक्स हैव बीन शोन हियर. यू हैव टू राइट द डिफरेंस इन बिटवीन इन योर नोटबुक. सो कैन यू टेल मी व्हाट्स द क्लॉक एंड व्हाट्स द यूज ऑफ इट. सो लेट मी क्लियर, द क्लॉक is one of the oldest human invention and it's a timekeeping device. It's used commonly in our home. Okay, why it is important in our life? It's an important material in our life because it is used by us to know the time. Okay, without the clock we cannot know what's the exact time it is. Usually with hands or changing numbers it indicates the hours and minutes. Now let's begin. Reading. Long ago in Europe there stood a little village right in the middle of a big forest. At one time the people of this village had been very skilled clockmakers, but now very few clocks were made there. The clever old clockmakers had passed away and their sons went to the towns to work and make money and have happier times than living in the village, which they called a slow and old place. Explanation. It's an European story. The whole story is revolves around the clock. This story is about the little village which was situated in the middle of a big forest. At once village was very flourished and famous for its unique clocks. People of this village had been very skilled clockmakers, but now days has changed. This village has called slow and old because the clever clockmakers had passed away and their sons went to the towns to work and make money. They have settled there over and spending happier days than the village. Second paragraph. The prince of the country visited the village and saw some of the lovely old clocks that had once been made there. He also heard that only a few of the good clockmakers were left. Explanation. One day the prince of the country visited the clock village and he seen some beautiful antique clocks. He had already heard only few clockmakers are left in his town. Okay, and the town has become slow and dull. In first paragraph you learnt about it. This village is called clock village. Why it's clock village? Because many skilled clockmakers were there and that village was very famous for its clocks. But now condition has changed and the town has become dull and slow. So that prince felt pity for them. Third paragraph. What a pity, he said, that such a good work should not stop. I will give a prize for the best clock that is made here during this winter. Explanation. The prince was very kind and clever. He felt pity about the villagers and he announced a competition. His intention was to begin the work as it previous and the villagers and village become happy and glorious as it previous. Next lines. News went all through the village and everyone who could make a clock work hard to win the prize. Explanation. The prince's idea of competition worked out and everybody who could make a clock began to work hard for the prize, like somebody get up from the sound sleep. Okay, and when he held the competition, yes, in the winter season. Next lines. Joseph lived with his old grandfather and in the long winter evenings when the snow lay thick in the forest, he used to sit beside his grandfather and watch him making wooden clocks until he too learned to make clocks. Explanation. Joseph was the little boy who was very active and always thinks out of the box. Out of the box means those who thinks differently with new perspective, means the way of thinking is different than ordinary people. He was staying with his old grandfather. Okay, he used to sit beside his grandfather and he learned how to make wooden clocks. Do you know, students, those students give respect and service to their parents and grandparents, always get blessing and succeed in their life. Do you know why it happened, why they get succeed? Yes, because older people like your parents and grandparents having a good and long experience of life. And if you take advantages of their experience, then you will get solution of each and every problem which comes in your life. That's why we should have to treat our parents and grandparents with kindness and courtesy. Next lines. Joseph asked his grandfather to help him win a prize, but his grandfather was not so sure. We are too poor to buy fine paint or enamel or gold or silver to make the clock look good. I fear our clock will be too plain. Joseph was eager to win the prize, so he asked his grandfather enthusiastically to help him in making the clock. But grandfather was not sure as they had not sufficient money to buy the material for it. Next page. Yes, said Joseph, but it will be very good and I am going to think of something new for it. But it is not easy to think of something that is both new and useful. Joseph thought for days while his grandfather waited for the improvement the boy would make. One day, Joseph went to the forest to fetch some wood. He saw a cuckoo perched on the branch of a tree. Explanation: Joseph was very creative and enthusiastic boy. He had been thinking about both something new and useful should be there in his clock. That clock should be something different than others. So, when he went into the forest to fetch the wood, he saw cuckoo perched on the branch of a tree. Perched means what? That cuckoo was resting on the branch of the tree. Next lines. Joseph thought to himself, I wish the cuckoo could give me a new thought, when all at once it did. Why? Of course, instead of just striking the hours, we will have a bird sing them instead. Joseph thought out loud. Explanation. As we know, Joseph had been thinking about something creative for his clock. And finally, the cuckoo gave the idea about his clock. And what's the idea? Yes, instead of just striking the hours, bird will have come out from its nest and sing the song. Okay, like cuckoo, cuckoo. It's something new and awesome. He screamed loudly with joy. Next lines. Joseph ran home like the wind to tell his grandfather about his new idea and to see if it could be carried out. Grandfather considered it for a long time and at last said, yes, I do believe we could make it, but first we must plan it out. Explanation. Suddenly Joseph got an idea by watching cuckoo and he was overjoyed. He ran home like a wind to tell his grandfather and he was sure about his idea, but he wanted to only check whether his idea is carried out or what. After hearing his magical words and his magical idea, his grandfather thought about it and begin his work happily. Next lines. So they got paper and pencil and a ruler and made plans of the clock and the cuckoo and the door through which the bird would come out. Explanation. Eventually the grandfather and Joseph sat with idea and they both commenced their work. They planned for the clock, cuckoo and the door through which the bird would come out. Next lines. They set to work and together they made a good strong clock. Alas, it was very plain to look at. Every day they heard of the wonders of their neighbor's clocks. One had beautiful fruits painted on its face. Another had enameled silver on it. Another was wonderfully carved. But grandfather said, never mind, Joseph. Ours is something new. It is a good clock and if it works well, we may get the prize. Explanation. As per the plan, grandfather and Joseph made together a good strong clock, but their happiness does not remain for a long time. Joseph get disappointed with his new clock because every day they had been hearing of the wonders of their neighbor's clocks. One had beautifully fruits painted on its face. Another had enameled. Enameled means what here? Means nicely decorated. Okay? Enameled silver on it. Someone have wonderfully carved. But grandfather has given confidence to disappointed Joseph and said that his clock is unique and innovative. So if it really good clock and it will work perfectly, then definitely you will get the prize from the prince. Next page. At last, the clock was finished, and grandfather wound it up. Wound it up means what? Wind up. Means close that work. And set it to 5 minutes to one. Never were 5 minutes so long as this time, while they both waited to see if it worked properly. Explanation. Ultimately, the clock was finished, and grandfather wind up his work and set the clock 5 minutes to one and were hold back to see if it worked or what. Next paragraph. At 1 o'clock, the little door opened. The bird came out, called cuckoo, and then went back. It works," cried Joseph. "It is a wonderful, and maybe we will get the prize." Explanation: the idea of cuckoo made them eager to see the result, and the result is his idea worked out pretty well. Both were pleased to see the little bird open the door, came out, and called cuckoo, and then it went back. With overjoyed heart, Joseph shouted, it works, and it's wonderful." He again hoped that he would win the prize from Prince. At last, the great day came. All the clocks were taken to the village hall to be judged. The prince and princess came and looked at them carefully. Explanation. As we know, Joseph and his grandfather both had been waiting for the day, and at last, the great day came. All the clockmakers had been presented in the judging hall, okay, with their beautiful and decorative clocks. Next lines. Some clocks were large and beautiful, some covered with paint, and some were carved and enameled. Joseph's heart sunk. His plain little clock stood in a corner and seemed quite lost. Explanation. Joseph's heart was sinking. Sinking means what? Feeling suddenly sadness. Okay, why his heart was sinking? At the moment when he saw a variety of beautiful and decorative clocks were there for competition. He had been started comparing his clock with others, like with design, color, and decoration. And he found his little clock has been stood in a corner and it seemed quite lost and plain. Okay, again he had lost the hopes of the prize. Next lines. Oh, if only it were near the hour and they could hear it strike. He thought, but it was only 10 minutes past. And he knew that in a short time, the prince would finish judging the clocks and go. At last, he could hold back no longer. "Please, sir, may I set my clock ahead and show how it strikes?" he said to the prince. "But which is your clock?" said the prince kindly. "You are a very young clockmaker." Explanation. When Prince had come to judging hall, that time it was only 10 minutes past 2. And Joseph was very eager to show how the birds come out and sing and go back to its place. But it would have possible only when clock hands complete 60 minutes. So he needs to wait till 3 o'clock. But he know that the prince will complete his judging in very short time and he would go back from the judging hall. By thinking over that all, he became impatient and requested to Prince to see the clock, how it strikes. As we know, the prince was very kind and clever. He agreed to see it and given compliment as he is very young clockmaker with kind and supportive words. Next lines. Joseph pointed out his clock and the prince smiled, for it was very, very plain and small. "Yes, set it to the hours, my boy," he said kindly. Explanation. When Joseph asked Prince to see the clock, Prince agreed immediately and Joseph shown his clock. By looking at the clock, the prince smiled because it was very plain and small. To encourage the little Joseph, the prince asked kindly to set the hours, my boy. Actually, the prince was very happy to see the little clockmakers. That's why, in spite of little and plain clock, he shown eagerness to see ours, how it works. Next lines. So Joseph turned the hands of the clock, and in a minute, it was 3 o'clock. Out popped the little bird, sing, and turn back, and the door shut, like this. Thank you. Next lines. Bravo, cried the prince, and the prince laughed. I chose this clock to be the winner. It has something quite new, and that is what we want. The prince cried in excitement, bravo. Bravo is a word used to express approval when a performer has done something well. Okay, so the prince shouted with cheerful heart and he said, I choose this clock to be the winner. It has something quite new and that is what we want. Okay, after the joyful announcement of prince, the Joseph's face became happy and his face spread the winning smile. Now last two paragraphs. Let's read. Joseph got the prize. And with the money, they bought a new cow and some goats. Soon they had so many orders for cuckoo clocks that they were kept busy all day. Till grandfather said, we must have a new workshop and some friends to help us. The cuckoo clocks were sent all over the world and the village became famous for its cuckoo clocks. Explanation. Joseph got the prize and his grandfather and Joseph became very happy. Actually, it's a reward for his creativity and hard work. With the prize money, they brought cow and some goats. Their day changed. Soon they had got so many orders for its unique cuckoo clocks. And it kept busy at all the day. The village became famous for its cuckoo clocks. The cuckoo clocks were sent all over the world. So, what we learn from this lesson? Yes, when we cultivate the qualities of confidence and clear-cut goal, we get the success. Do you know the prince gave the prize to Joseph for his wooden clock, though there were more precious clocks. Why it happened? Yes, because success needs something extraordinary. Joseph's way of thinking and his willingness made him a successful boy. Now let's solve the comprehension. Write true or false for the following. The prince saw some ugly clocks. This sentence is false. Yes, there were in the judging hall, there were so many beautiful clocks were there. Second question. Joseph lived with his grandfather. Yes, it's true. He was living with his grandfather. The cuckoo did not help Joseph. This answer is false. Actually, cuckoo only help him. She only gave the idea. Fourth one, Joseph's clock was plain and ordinary. Answer is false. Yes, his clock was plain, but it's extraordinary. Next question, Joseph won the prize. Yes, it's true. Joseph won the prize because his clock was extraordinary and there was something new. That prince liked it very much. Now let's discuss the question answer. Give two reasons why very few clocks were made in the village. Answer. At one time, that village was very flourished and famous for its clock. But afterwards, what happened? The clever old clockmakers had passed away. This is the first reason. And what is the second reason? Their sons went to the towns to work and make money. And they have happier life there over. They settle it there only. Next question. Why did the prince announce a competition for the best clock? What answer would come? Yes, the prince was very kind and clever person. He felt very pity about the villagers and village. That's why he announced the competition. And what's the intention behind of it? Yes, to get a glorious days to that village as previous. Third question. Who gave Joseph a new idea about his clock? What was the idea? So what answer would be? Yes. Who had given the idea? The cuckoo had given the idea to Joseph. And what was the idea? The idea was that little bird will come out from the nest. He will say the cuckoo. He will sing a song, little song, and again go back to its place. Next question. Why was Joseph disheartened with his new clock? What is the answer? Actually, Joseph was very happy about his new idea and his clock. But afterwards, when he listened about the people, those are staying neighbor,
Those are neighbors. They said that their clocks are very beautiful. They have made it so much of decoration and fruits and leaves and like this. They were decorated. And as compared to them, his clock was very simple and plain. That's why he became disheartened. Question number 5th. At last he could hold no longer. What could Joseph hold no longer? He could not wait for no longer. He was not having patience because he knew that very well that Prince would go earlier and his clock will remain like that only. That's why. Second question. What did he ask for the prince? He asked the prince, he requested the prince to wait and just see how it strike. Next question, third one. Did the prince grant him his permission? Yes, the prince was very kind and he granted his permission and also seen also how it strikes, how it work. Now question number 6th. How did the village become famous? So what answer would come? Yes, the village became famous for its cuckoo clocks. Okay, the cuckoo clocks were sent all over the world. So many orders they had got it from the peoples to make a cuckoo clock. Thanks for the watching. Keep learning.